Hello and welcome to Actions and Code Reusability, where we will be talking about how you can organize your code into actions to allow it being called from multiple places, what statements exist in out systems for code flow control and branching, and how outputs of actions are affected by this very same code branching. The way you can create your code so that it is reusable is through actions. Now you already know screen actions. That's where you have implemented behaviors that are very specific to a screen, but there's also user actions, where you can define logic that can be called from any other action. When you create an action, you can define it to have any number of input parameters and their respective types, as well as output parameters. Should you want to call your code from an expression, you can flag it to be a function. But then you'd need to make sure that it only has one output parameter. So what is an action? An action is a sequence of statements that are executed in a certain order. An action flow always starts with a start node and can end in an end node, and that's normally how you end it. In case you're implementing a screen action, it can actually finish in a download or a destination. It's possible to have subflows inside an action flow for exception handlers, and we will cover this in a different lesson. Now, one of the most common statements that you will find in an action flow is an assign statement. An assign statement, as its name indicates, allows you to assign values to variables. Inside an assign statement, you can actually have several sub-statements, and they're executed from top to bottom. And the OutSystems platform gives you a few accelerators when you need to bulk assign attributes, for example, of an entity to another entity. It's worth noting that assignments in the OutSystems platform for most data types is done by value. The exceptions are lists, binary data, and objects, which are done by reference, meaning that any changes that you make to the source will be visible on the target of an assign at a later point. If you want to simulate a by-value behavior on a list, if you really want to duplicate the list and detach it from the original, use the list duplicate system action. Now, a simple action can be just a direct sequence of other action calls. However, in most scenarios, you will need to make decisions and branch and do different behaviors depending on certain conditions. So what kind of mechanics does the OutSystems platform give you to branch your code? The simplest one is the if statement. The if provides you with a condition that is evaluated at runtime, and depending on what it evaluates to, true or false, it takes one branch or the other. The switch statement behaves very much like a chaining of if statements. On the switch, you define a set of conditions. And if the condition 1 is fulfilled, it takes the branch for condition 1. If condition 2 is fulfilled, it takes the branch for condition 2. Otherwise, it takes the remaining branch. And finally, there's the for each statement that allows you to iterate through any list and execute code on every record of that list. As long as the list has items, the cycle branch is followed, and upon executing your custom code, it should come back to the for each node. After the list is deplenished, the other branch is taken and the for each exits. Please note that the for each is an iterator over a specified list. It's not a generic while statement. Should you want to implement a generic while behavior, just use the if statement, as it's shown over here. If the condition is true, you take your action, otherwise you bail out, therefore implementing a non-list dependent loop. It's important to clarify what impact branching code execution has on the outputs of action calls. If you assume that every single of these actions has got one output parameter called out, please note that the outputs inside of a particular branch are only visible while you are in that code branch. As soon as you rejoin a common branch, these will no longer be visible. So in this particular case, the output of action left is not visible in the assign right or assign common. The output of action right, in turn, is not visible in the assigned left or assigned common. Action before, since the compiler knows has been executed at all points, it will be visible on all the assigned statements that you see here. And finally, action after that's executed when the flow is rejoined is only seen in the very last assign. While we have been focusing on the base OutSystems language, where we write code using a fairly atomic code statements, the OutSystems platform actually contains its own business process visual language that enables the design of fairly high-level business processes and workflows. On the right-hand side of the slide, you can see an actual BPT flow example, where a few automatic activities, like assigning a reviewer, work together with a human activity, where this reviewer will need to check some credits, to make a decision on every single loan application that comes into the system. These asynchronous activities, in turn, use the base OutSystems concepts and language we've been talking about, providing a seamless experience to the developer while using Service Studio. Since the BPT language is actually a domain of its own, we will not cover it at all in this course, but if you want to know more, please check the dedicated online course by following the link at the bottom of the slide. And that's it for actions and code reusability. Hope this was useful. See you guys in the next lesson.